Hello everyone, I'm Lucy Gunawan, the head of the data science practice at TIMI. This video is the fourth installment in a series of tutorials about the integration between Anatella and Azure. In the previous videos, we learned how to connect to SharePoint and manage all your files and drive inside SharePoint. In this video, I'll walk you through the process of manipulating SharePoint lists and list items using Anatella. Lists inside SharePoint are like Excel spreadsheets. The advantage of using lists over Excel sheets is that they facilitate teamwork by allowing multiple users to access and update the same datasheet simultaneously. This is often not possible with standalone Excel files. If you're looking to access files rather than lists inside SharePoint, I recommend checking out the previous video in this series titled Accessing Azure SharePoint Drive or Libraries. Click here to watch this video. Now, let's dive into how you can manipulate lists and list items using Anatella. In this tutorial, you will learn how to use Anatella to retrieve an enumeration of all the lists inside a SharePoint site, to retrieve all the list items from a specific list from SharePoint, to create a new list or override them if they already exist, to append items to lists, to delete lists, to update items inside some lists. To get started, you'll need two essential pieces of information, the Azure Application ID and the Anatella Unlock Key. The process of obtaining the Azure Application ID is covered in the video titled Anatella First Time Setup to Access Azure App Registration. Click here to watch this video. The process of obtaining the Anatella Unlock Key is covered in the second video of this tutorial titled Getting Your Personal Anatella Unlock Key. Click here to watch this video. Open your web browser and navigate to the SharePoint site that you want to access. Take note of the SharePoint site URL address. In our example, it's timi312sharepoint.com/demo2. The SharePoint site contains a list called My List that we would like to access using Anatella. Let's proceed by enumerating all the available lists within the Timi SharePoint site. Create a SharePoint list.anatella and open it. To begin, let's search for SharePoint inside the Anatella search bar. Next, drag and drop the SharePoint list box from the drop-down menu onto the Anatella graph. Inside the Connection Parameters tab, input the Azure Application ID and the Anatella Unlock Key. Navigate to the Standard Parameter tab and select Get List from the Operation drop-down menu. Next, let's choose the SharePoint site that we want to access. You can do this by clicking the combo box and selecting your SharePoint site from the drop-down list. This method is convenient when you only have a few well-identified SharePoint sites. Alternatively, you can choose your SharePoint site by copying and pasting the URL that you see in your web browser when navigating to your SharePoint site. In our example, it was timi312.sharepoint.com/demo2. The second approach is more convenient when you have a large number of SharePoint sites to choose from. It makes sure you select the correct one. Now, let's execute the box. This confirms the existence of a list named MyList inside our SharePoint site. Let's continue with the exercise. Let's proceed to download a complete list, along with all its items, inside Anatella. To streamline this process, you can replicate the previous example, saving time on filling the connection parameters. To duplicate the previous box, hold on the Ctrl key while clicking and dragging the box. Next, to retrieve all the items from a list within the demo site, set the operation drop-down menu to get items. We keep the site as demo. We specify the list name from the drop-down menu as my list. Execute the process. When examining the resulting data, you'll find that the title column and my number column are displayed, along with some additional information. By comparing this data with the information displayed on the SharePoint website inside the browser, you can observe the consistency between the two. Let's create a new list, but be careful with this option because it will override the same list if it already exists in SharePoint. Drag and drop the SharePoint upload box from the search bar. Let's fill the connection parameters, the application ID, and the Anatella unlock key. Inside the standard parameter tab, choose the mode as Manage List on SharePoint. Set the site parameter as Demo. Select the operation as Create List. Type in the list name as My List Version 2. And execute the box. Now, let's check if this new list has been created inside SharePoint. To do so, open the section named Site Content on the SharePoint website. Yes, it's there! Please note that for some reason, the new list created directly with Anatella do not appear in the shortcut on the left menu. Let's retrieve the content of my list version 2 using Anatella. Yes, there it is in the output table. Let's demonstrate the process of appending items to an existing list in SharePoint. In my list version 2, there are two columns, title and my number. Currently, it has 10 rows. I have prepared a small inline table with these two same columns. Now, I'd like to add the three rows from my inline table to the list named My List Version 2 on SharePoint. Next, drag and drop SharePoint upload box. The two connection parameters, the application ID and the Anatella unlock key are already properly set. In the standard parameter tab, choose the operation as append list. Execute the box. Now, let's check if the items have been correctly uploaded to My List Version 2 on the SharePoint sites. We can see that it has now 13 rows. It works! Let's demonstrate the process of updating some items inside an existing list in SharePoint. I have here a little inline table with three columns, ID, title, and my number. There are two rows inside this inline table that we would like to update inside SharePoint. Let's copy the previous SharePoint upload box. Inside the standard parameter tab, we change the operation to update list. We choose the list name as my list version 2. Now we need to specify the two IDs of the two rows that we will update. How do we get these IDs? Let's run the SharePoint download box again to see the complete list named My List Version 2 from SharePoint. In the output table, you can see a column named ID that contains exactly the IDs that we need. Let's say now that we want to update these two rows. The rows with the IDs 3 and 4. Then, we write 3 and 4 inside the column ID inside our little inline table. And we select the column ID as the parameter column item ID. Let's execute the box. Let's check that the item have been correctly updated inside the My List Version 2 list on the SharePoint site. Yes, you can see the new content here. To proceed with the deletion of a previously created list, let's copy the previous box. And inside the Standard Type Parameter tab, change the operation to delete list. We choose the list name from the drop-down, it's MyList version 2. Execute the process. As a result, the MyList version 2 is no longer in SharePoint. There you have it. In this video, you learn how to enumerate the list from a SharePoint site, download a complete list with all its items from a SharePoint site, create a new list, append rows to a list, update a list, delete a list. Thank you for joining me in this tutorial. If you have any questions or need further clarification on any of the topics we covered today, please feel free to leave a comment down below. Your feedback is highly valued, and if you found this video helpful, don't hesitate to give it a thumbs up. Your support means a lot to us. If you're interested in more tutorial, engaging discussion, and useful tips, consider subscribing to our channel. By doing so, you'll stay informed and won't miss out on our upcoming content. I now invite you to click here to watch the next video in this series about the integration between Anatella and Azure. In this fifth and the final video, we'll provide some best practices for storing your SharePoint credential inside a config file that you can easily reuse inside all your graphs. See you next time!